Continuing with the topic of methods that belong to classes, I want to discuss like one very useful technique that I use all the time and that I really encourage you to take a look at. And it is the fact that very often, for example, when we create objects, right? Objects have a lot of properties inside of them: name, year, blah blah blah, whatever. So, and I can create them with a constructor in a very lean, fast way. Okay, and it turns out that if I had a very complicated program, right, that I created an object, or I created an object, and then at some point I wanted to just check visually in the console all the properties of that object, then it would be a little tedious, because right now, remember, I would have to write something like this, where I would have to write for each one of the properties, I would have to write a console write line situation and print the name, the age, the height, whether the person is alive or not, etc. But this is a little cumbersome, because for four properties, maybe it's fine, but if I had like 17 of them, maybe it's a little too much. I may want to do something where I just want to print the object itself, the whole thing. I just want to throw it into the console and get a printout. But with the default techniques, it turns out that what is going on here? Wow! My keyboard is kind of crazy today. It turns out that if I just throw the object into the console without any other thing, what I get is this default string representation of the object, which is the name of the class and the namespace that it belongs to. All right, but it doesn't really print the information. Why doesn't it print the information? Well, the computer assumes that these objects can be of any shape with any kind of properties, whatever, and it doesn't know really what you may want to print. So it defaults to this string representation that is honestly not very useful. So what we may want to do is we may want to customize how, by default, objects get stringified, how objects become string representations of themselves. And the idea to do that is that we can go to our class, and then we can use a special method that all objects in C# have. I'm not going to get into the details of this, but when you create an object, when you create a class, all classes inherit some really, really, really basic functionality from the ideal class, which is the class object. This is very, I'm not going to get into what this means, but what it means is that by default, without you even saying it explicitly, every class that you create has a method called toString. And that is a method that is called whenever an object needs to be turned into a string so that it can perform some function, like, for example, showing up on the console. So even though we haven't talked about this yet, but this here is printing because secretly the compiler is calling the toString method of this object, and this is what that method returns. We don't have control over that, because that is something that is being given to us out of the box, almost secretly, from the C# environment. But it turns out that we can actually customize that behavior. So what I can do here is I can go and say, I could write a function here that returns a string, and I'm going to call it toString, all right? And this has to have this one particular name, all right? This is the name of the function that is a standard default method in C# environment, all right? And what I can do here is I can create a string representation. I can customize how this string is going to look like for me. So, for example, a way to do that is it's going to be string obj, and I may just want to represent this object like this. So, for example, the object is going to be represented with like square brackets, and then here I'm going to write this dot name, all right? And then the second one is going to be the age. So instead of using the year of birth, I may want to represent the age. So I can call the getAge method and print the return of that method. Here I may want to print the height, all right? And here I may want to print whether if this person is alive or not. And then I may want to close the square brackets, and or without the square brackets, because I don't want to indicate that this is an array. It's not really an array. And then I can return this object. All right. Remember that here I'm using string literals. I made a video on string literals at some point. It was somewhere in the playlist. Okay. And the only thing that I need to remember is that toString as a method already exists in objects in C sharp. So I need to add a particular clause here that is called override to say, I don't want you to use the default implementation, the one that gave me the namespace and the name of the class. I want you to use this one that I just wrote here. So that's why I want to override the default behavior that the toString method that comes out of the box uses. And I want you to override it with this particular implementation that I just created. And what's nice about this is that now when I print the object, this object is going to serialize itself into a string that is going to look like the format that I just wrote here. The name, comma, age, comma, height, and whether if it's alive or not. All right. I could fancy this up by writing name, colon, Jose, age, colon, 70, whatever you want. At the end of the day, this is about how do you want to customize how this object looks like when it becomes a string by default, all right? So when creating classes, it's super, super useful to customize the string method, the toString method, so that when you are developing and when you're printing to the console or when things just need to become strings, then they use this method instead of the default implementation, all right? I really encourage you when writing classes to do that for yourself. It's very useful and it's very, you will be very happy with yourself. Okay. All right, let's move on.